Hey guys, check out my dates, michaelandog.com.
Hi, this episode is brought to you by Viagra. Mm-hmm. You know, you don't need me to fucking even sell it. Just reminding you that you shouldn't be ashamed about it. You can have some. This week we have Alexis Siegel.
Alexandra.
Oh, my bad.
Are you kidding me, Michael?
I was thinking of your like handle on Instagram.
I know, but it's Alex.
I thought it was Alex's Siegel.
No, it's Princess Alex Siegel.
Princess, because she knows she'll never be a queen. Princess Alexandra Siegel.
Yes, thank you.
And she is a beautiful, talented actress that has not made it yet. And
takes one to know one, but you know.
Yes, very mm-hmm. true.
Yes, very true.
And I've known her for, I would say, 8 years on and off.
Was it 8 years? Six.
Six. 2018. Oh, 6 years ago, yeah. I met her and I crawled into her bedroom.
Well, now, I came to yours.
What?
To your bedroom.
You came to mine.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. So we'll get into that. I don't even recall what it was. But Mark is married and he's a sweet guy, but I could feel his energy. Like he's not ready to be open yet. Like he's a little nervous around you.
Totally.
I think he gets nervous around other women. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No, it's, I feel like there is an ambush coming.
You think we're coming at you?
Because I'm like, they've had time to prepare something and I'm just casing what it's going to
no,
be.
No, Mark, this isn't about you.
Oh,
you
I know I it's not. It can't be about me because I'm not on camera.
Yes, this wouldn't be about you. We're just kind of checking in. But Alexandra's a very beautiful, talented actress, podcaster now. And
first time
there's a first time
first
for everything
time. There sure is.
And she's available, guys.
She is available.
She always has been available since I've known her.
Lord knows
she came. I met her when she was leaving a relationship.
I had one since then.
You've had one relationship.
I had one.
Who'd you date?
A crazy Irish guy for a year. My rebound after you.
After me?
Yeah.
Well,
we didn't really.
We didn't date, but like there was a lot of people like me in between. No. Let's not just say I was the only one.
No, you were one of many.
Yes.
You were in a grouping. That was a phase.
Okay, but you had a relationship.
I did, yeah.
Like an I love you relationship?
Oh, no? Yeah.
I didn't know this. You never posted about it, which is a red flag.
Well, he was a red flag. It was right before the pandemic. We broke up in 2020.
So you were dating and you never posted anything on social media. Don't you think that's a little weird?
I don't think I ever, no, because I don't post any of my boyfriends on social media. I like to keep the options
What
open.
If it's 2 years in, you're in love, you think you're going to marry him? You're not
if
posting
If I'm in
a
love
picture?
And I think I'm going to marry him, I'll post him on social media. But I've never felt like I'm going to marry the person that I'm with, so I never posted.
Okay, but not posting someone.
And also, too, it's about me. It's not about him.
Okay, but your eyes are rolling already.
Oh, because I'm sitting there, I'm like, my wife and I, we don't post about each other.
You posted about your ex.
Yes, but that's different because I'm putting my life out there. It's my business too.
Yeah.
You're not, so it's different. She puts her life out there. She's an actress. Hey, she posts when she's back at home with her family. So it's not like you're only exclusively like you're being an actress, but you're also posting personal stuff.
Yeah, absolutely.
So would that not be considered kind of like that's interesting. Like how long are you dating someone? We got something already, right? This is a thing. How long are you dating someone before it's uncomfortable that you haven't posted about them on social media? And I'm not talking about a story, right? Because that's a 24-hour thing that goes away.
Yeah, I would put someone in my story.
You would?
I would.
Okay.
If I was dating them.
No, the Irish guy, did you post them on your story?
Yeah.
Okay.
A little. I was kind of embarrassed about him. But
is there a rule? Like, would you be offended if you were dating a guy and it had been 6 months and he never posted you?
No.
You would not?
No. I don't care. I don't want him to post me. He doesn't deserve it. Let me tell you something. Like,
I say 2 months. Two months? 2 months is like, hey.
I mean, I wouldn't want.
We've been.
Wait. 2 months for a hard post?
For like a just. Something like, oh, I'm doing something fun with this person.
I dated someone for a month last year, and they're in a 3-month relationship, hard post, very serious. So it's like weird. Some people go faster.
I love
than
that you
people.
Call it like a hard post. Like
that's what they call it. Like
who
oh,
cares?
Because that's what it's called. Like when you actually
like, no,
out.
I get it.
It is a who cares, but that hey, it's 2024, young man, And that's what it is. We live in a world where, like, have they done a what is it called? A hard release or something
yeah.
like that?
Oh, yeah. A hard. Is it a hard release?
It's a press give you, release. I'll give you a hard release. Anyway, it's sorry. That I had you to care do a little sexual this. Harassment. Well, understand. Yeah. A hard.
A hard launch.
Hard launch. Yeah. Yes. So.
You care about this, which is interesting. Why do you think that is?
I think that it's it makes the other person feel good.
Okay.
I think it would be a relief if someone didn't care about it.
It's attention seeking.
I don't think so. No. I think we live in a world that is online. So is everything attention seeking? You even you post, and if you post something that you're proud of, why is that you want to share it with your friends and family in the world? Like, hey, look at this. I'm in love and I want to share it and I'm proud of it. Why is that attention seeking? Like you want to be like, hey, attention seeking would be setting up a day for everyone to come fly in and visit and watch you guys make out and then have a dance party.
A wedding is attention
seeking way more than posting a picture on an Instagram. So there's my argument towards
you. What do you think about this?
I'm just laughing that his false equivalency of that, like, oh man, because your whole bit is the I'm 40 and not married.
Yeah, I know. And maybe that will stay that way. Mm-hmm. But I'm not married because I've seen what's out there. And guys, well, it's crazy.
I thought we moved to like Michael Lenoci, it's professional me. Dater.
What's that?
I thought we moved to Michael Lenoci, professional dater.
And that's what we're doing. We're on a date right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you for joining us.
With Alexandra.
Oh, wonderful. This is
we never date. Actually went on a date.
No,
I just,
he never took
I
on a
single
date.
I was charming enough to get her to come over.
Was it charm? Or you had just, I just given up?
You had given up. You were just lonely.
I was relenting.
We met on Raya.
We met on Raya. Your opener was hi.
No, it wasn't.
Yes,
really?
It was. It was hi.
Oh man, it's evolved. But since
I was going to say this is a different Michael.
Yeah, mine's evolved.
Oh, I see. I feel like you're the only one who could pull that off. It's got to be someone whose aura is like funny.
Well, that's how you text me. You literally text me today. Hi.
Everyone, I always, that's how I start. I go, hi.
I
want the check-in, what and then I go, let's
need?
Get to business.
Right.
Hi. And then I want you to say hi and go, okay, you're present. Let's go. Let's talk. Rather than asking a question and then that question's just sitting in the universe waiting for an answer. That's ridiculous. Mm-hmm. That's a ridiculous way to live.
Well, mm-hmm. Let me ask you this, because I'm finding I'm that person who will immediately send a text as if like we've just been talking, even though I haven't texted you in like 6 months.
Yeah.
But you do the hi, the small talk first.
Yeah. Hi. Then you say hi, because I'm always on my phone. I'm immediately responding. Rare, like there's a few situations where I'm not on my phone. And,
what's
you
that?
Know, shower. And that's it. Or on stage. If I'm on stage, I'm in the shower or I'm
inging. Oh, I know what that is.
So, yeah. Bad person. Doesn't post about a boyfriend. Well, Irish guy. I have an Irish guy for you that you could date.
Oh, do you?
My buddy Mark.
I like guys from the UK.
Oh.
Those are my type.
So that's British.
Well, and Ireland.
Oh.
It's yeah. United Kingdom.
Oh.
United Kingdom. Isn't your mom from?
Was. She's dead. Was.
Yes.
She's
yes.
dead.
I walked into that one. My bad.
She's dead. Yes. Were you just talking to the camera yourself? Yeah, just I doing was. A little thing? Mm-hmm. Wait, so you dated this Irish guy?
Yeah, I dated this Irish guy. And like the thing is, I post for entertainment purposes. I don't post. It's not anyone's business. And this is a provocative statement. But you see a lot of women who are like, who start to post about being pregnant or something like that, and they lose followers, which is ridiculous.
They do.
They lose followers because of it. So I feel like a lot of my demographic is, you know,
perverted men.
Perverted men who live in their mom's basement. And so I'm not going to, for work purposes, post about a guy if I don't need to, unless it was like my wedding.
But you're not selling tickets. So what
no,
does
No, I'm
it
not
matter?
Selling tickets, but I'm like, you know, I like
you
the
like
attention.
The attention.
Exactly.
Even the way you talk, you're very proud of yourself. The way you talk,
I love attention.
You're a natural performer.
I am a natural performer, and it's the business. It's work.
Yeah, I remember when we did hang out. I would always think about, oh, I could never date you.
Why?
Because I would, I feel like you're permit. I wouldn't be able to trust you. I feel
Why?
Like you would be not. I feel like you would always be open to the next best thing. I feel like if we were dating, another guy would come in, like a 6'4" guy could come in and just be like, you know, I'll get you in a movie. And you'd be like,
okay. Oh, so I make you insecure.
You would make me insecure.
Really? I feel like I'm a really honorable person.
You could be, but I feel like our dynamic was very, you know, it was just very.
If you pissed me off.
Well, we would fight all the time.
Because that's the thing. We would fight all the time, and then maybe I would retaliate.
Yeah, we would fight.
By trying to make you jealous.
You would argue a lot because you would disagree with me, and I was mostly right.
But also, too, I was like easily irked at that time. I was going through a hard time, Michael.
Were you?
Kind of. Remember, I just got out of a relationship.
Yeah, I guess. You know, I'm half listening.
Right.
You know, I'm just like, hey, do you want to come over? Do you want to hang out?
Yeah.
We hung out for what? A couple times or a few?
I don't know. It feels like we hung out more than we actually did, doesn't it?
We've over 10 times, right?
Did we?
I don't know. I forget.
I think it ended pretty quickly and then it would restart again.
I remember a couple times when you lived with your sisters.
I live with my sister.
That's when we had that thing about the mirror thing you brought up the other day.
Okay. Let's.
Whatever. It was a thing. Hey, what's going Michael on? You okay?
Yeah. I don't know. I'm just following along. Oh, okay. I'm watching this dynamic.
You think we're cute?
It's funny to me.
Well, I want to know.
I know. I'm enjoying it because like it's going exactly how I thought. Were you talking about so the relationship? Cryptic. Like you would annoy the shit out of her.
Well,
might retaliate.
We're probably not compatible. Like in the same household, if we were like in love living together and you know, whatever, like, It wasn't.
But you would kill as like wingman, wingwoman for each other.
Well, it's actually, there's a moment that's happened recently.
Mm-hmm.
She like one of her friends, and you know that, you know, she's like, you should meet her, and I'm like, I've met her.
That's not how it happened, but
exactly. Yeah, it's not how it happened. It happened organically on my own. Yeah, but we actually met up during the pandemic. We were both lonely and we tried to hang out and I went over her house,
mm-hmm.
and we were like talking and then we tried to hook up and then we were both like, this is,
we bad. Stopped. We were full nude and
full
stopped.
Nude.
Full nude.
Full nude.
It was the most unsexual experience of my life.
It was pretty bad.
Yeah.
We were both sitting there and it was like, we just masturbated like a brother and sister that were lonely. We were just sitting there going, Oh, this is not, there's no chemistry here.
Yeah. That shit only happened in movies.
Oh, it was pretty, it was like, well, you know, maybe we'll hang out, you know, maybe we'll.
We decided to be friends in that moment. And then we never spoke again.
Did you shake hands after?
It wasn't like uncomfortable. No, it was just really more wasn't. Like very like.
It sounds really uncomfortable.
But it wasn't. We were both sitting there going like, I've never been like in a moment of being like, oh, well, this was a bad idea.
Right. We couldn't pinpoint why though necessarily.
You know what's funny, hanging out with you, and I've seen you a lot recently in the last week, it's like
He's got a crush on me.
You're fun.
Michael,
you're
stop.
A fun person.
Okay, good. Let's move
you're
on.
You're getting flustered.
No, right? You're like embarrassing me.
Yeah, because I'm calling because she likes it.
No.
She does like it a little bit.
Don't we laugh.
Wow. This is gonna
So anyways.
Anyways, so yes.
Okay, this is your podcast. I'm happy to be here. It's so
yes.
cute, your little
studio. So we have
studio.
A couple things. Right. Wait, what were we talking about before we started? There was something about like a date situation.
My ex-boyfriend posting thing people on Instagram.
Oh yeah, that's not for you.
That's not for me. My Irish ex. How we wouldn't be compatible.
Yes. And now you're still young.
Exactly.
But why do you think you want to be single? You enjoy it.
Michael, I got to tell you. No, I do. This is what I would say. I prefer to be single and like being single more than I do being stuck in something with a guy or feeling like I'm being controlled
by
a guy.
Exactly what I would diagnose him with.
Okay.
Well, no, listen, I think that we should all be the loves of our own lives. And that's important. I think a lot of people land with whomever they're with because they're like tired of being alone.
You mean they settle?
They settle.
I mean, a topic that has been hot on this podcast and I've been clipping it out and people get mad at
this. People get mad. Well, I'm a woman and I'm here telling you that I think that this is how it is.
People
are settling. Oh, yep. Everyone's settling.
Oh, okay. Right. But way less today. They were settling back in the day.
That's why so many marriages end in divorce. Like, I think also, too, I had a really long relationship, 6 years, and then I had, like, my crazy rebound toxic relationship up there. So I know,
what's your
like,
body number at?
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
So I know what the good on paper great guy is who wasn't right for me, and I know what the toxic thing is. So I'm very in tune with like what I like, what isn't good, what isn't is.
What so can you so, meet a guy and within the first couple of dates know if he would be compatible for you?
1000%.
Me too.
I know the minute I talk to somebody.
Really?
Well, I'm trying to be better about like keeping an open mind.
Have you come to a realization that you're going to have to end up, if you want to be happily married, that you're going to have to end up with like a sort of beta type of guy? Have you realized that? You know that's
okay,
true.
Okay, I'll tell you this.
Because you have this alpha mentality. Yeah, you're very controlling.
Well, how do you, I'm not controlling.
You're not submissive.
Sometimes.
Never saw that side of it.
Well, because you couldn't.
Wait, so don't you think that you would need more of like a guy you could kind of, not in a bad terms, I don't know, I don't have a vocabulary big enough to describe it in any other way of walking over someone?
No, I think that there are different types of alphas. Okay. I only go for alphas, but I think the alpha but the ones that are combative with me are tough. But I kind of like that. I'm attracted to it, of course.
That because we would argue.
Whoa. But I'd win. But sure. But I feel like there are times of alphas that I like the kind of alpha, or I think the kind of alpha that's right for me is the stoic, quiet one who's like the alpha.
Ooh,
but he lets you take
so
the
confident.
So confident that he doesn't need to like compete. Because I have to be the like butterfly. I have to be the center of the stage. But he can be back and still, you know, running the show.
That could also be frustrating for you, which turns you on because he's just sitting there and you're like, are you just not upset at me? And he's like.
I think that's why I like guys from the UK, because like there's something a little bit like different about them. If it's just like an American guy, I'd be like.
What about American guys that can play a UK guy?
They're just idiots. They're idiots. They're like you.
Oh, and so when's the last time you were in a serious relationship?
I broke up with him in 2020.
So 4 years, almost 5 years now.
Yeah.
Just out in the streets being crazy.
Dude, out in these streets. And though, it's fun. It's wild. It's fun. Well, it gets lonely. Wouldn't you agree?
But you have a guy that you can kind of, do you have a cuddle guy or no? Or did you just have a?
I circulate like every 2 weeks.
You're kind of like a guy. You have a rotate. You're saying you have a rotation.
A little bit, but like that rotation will.
Could your rotation win a World Series? Do you have like more than three?
Right now?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't have a rotation in terms of ones that would come over and be in my bed. I do have a rotation in terms of ones I'm speaking to.
How about this? If we had clipped this part and it's posted on your Instagram, is it going to hurt someone's feelings?
Sure.
That's great.
I really don't care about hurting people's feelings, if I'm being honest. I don't care about hurting men's feelings. I care about hurting women's feelings.
Yeah, you hate men.
I don't hate them. I just think they're stupid.
But I watched you. I was watching you talk with your friend the other day when we met, and you were very empathetic for her, and you were like a good friend the way you were talking to her.
I'm a really good friend.
Yeah, I saw a side of you that I was really like proud of and made me like, oh, I should keep you in my life more often.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I will say this, I'm very empathetic and sweet with men too. I just feel like there needs to be something shaken up a little bit.
Oh, don't you think there was enough shaking up with the Me Too movement?
Oh, I'm not done with it, to be honest with you. No, there was shaking up. That was specific shaking up. They need like personality shaking up a little.
Like you want a woman in office.
Let's not talk about politics. Yeah, I mean, sure. I don't need it to be a woman in office. But like, yeah, I would think that would be cool. I think I should be the president.
The world, it would be a disaster. Oh, you would sleep with all the world leaders.
It would be a mess. Well, maybe we'd get something done. You know, I mean, I think.
Or not. Or nothing would get done because everybody would just be relaxed.
Yes, exactly. Okay. That is the key to world peace.
Oh,
me having my hand on every world leader. Yeah.
If there's one person that could pull that off, it would probably be you.
It probably would be.
Okay, so what? Let's do the small hand, big thing. Mark, you wouldn't have heard about this because, you know, you're miserably married. And I'm just kidding. So
he has kids?
No.
Oh. He has a dog.
Oh.
Yeah.
What kind?
Husky.
Cute.
Did you want to continue to get to know him?
Well, I just wanted to. I have one more question. Ahead. Does he do that like crying, talking thing?
He only like grumbles, but he's not a screamer.
He's
grumbles.
A screamer. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So
I'll do the woo stuff.
You're going to fucking find this fascinating.
Yeah.
Okay.
A girl, I was talking to a girl, we were on a date and she was telling me that hands came up. Maybe hands come up all the time. She had small hands or something like that. And she goes, are you doing the hand thing? And I go, what are you talking about the hand thing? And there's guys, and I said this to her before we start recording. She goes, that's happened to me too. Guys will be on a date with a woman and they'll be like, oh, you have small hands. Let me see. Mm-hmm. And they'll do this. And then they'll be like, and then they'll pull them in for a kiss.
Oh, they'll lock their so hands cringe.
In and pull them in. By the way, do you think this is on camera?
Why did you skip the kiss?
Do you think this is on camera?
I mean, it might be on camera, but.
Whatever. So they lock hands. If you want to put your hand over here for the camera. So they lock hands.
Are you guys seeing this? Hold on. I want to show you how what they do.
So they lock hands.
This is right.
And then he pulls her in. And then they like pull you in for a kiss. Like it's like it's like a romantic thing happening.
Yeah. This
is that not the
me.
Cheesiest
that is
goddamn thing I've ever heard.
That is the seventh grade cheesiest
and
shit.
And that's
ever.
How this is a real
and
thing.
And this is this working?
I guess it's putting, well, I think so. The girl I was with told me, she's like, the first time it happened, I was like, oh, that, like, whatever, cute, smooth.
This feels but then like when a it vine.
Happened, but when it happened twice, she, you know, replayed it and she goes, oh, this is, that's gross. It's like sad. It's like, there's a lot of guys out there, maybe lack of personality or they're on a script.
Right. Well, it kills a few birds with one stone. It shows the girl that they have big hands, which they think means something
or small.
Specific.
Oh, the guy. Gotcha.
Yeah. Or like it shows the comparison. It's a way to touch the girl. And also too, like, I think they think that it's like the girl likes it because she feels like little and feminine.
Mm. Or, yeah, it's their way of doing a kiss that's less awkward than not. It's you know what it is? It's for guys who can't read the room.
Yes.
And it's a way for them, like, how am I going to do the first kiss? How am I going to? Because I'll bet you there's a lot of guys out there, like, how am I going to do the first kiss? How am I going to do the first kiss? When can I do the first kiss?
Whereas, and they're
like,
not listening.
I'll just, like, be like, I'll literally just pull my car up to the park near my house. The moon's out over the ocean. I go, look, this is romantic. I'm going to get out of the car. We're going to walk up and I'm going to kiss you. And I just right. tell them how it's going to go. I go, we're shooting a scene.
I really wish that you didn't do that.
We're shooting a scene.
Well, wait. What's more cringe? Him telling her what he's going to do, or the hand thing?
Come
that's
on,
that's a really good question.
The hand thing is so cringe.
Oh, no. Whereas the hand thing is so bad. But I'm in their defense, and I don't want to defend it. Is like post college, we had the whole thing that came out. Was it the game?
Yeah, I read,
and
it.
That was.
I could
rewrite cheesy it. As fuck.
What's the game?
The game wasn't cheesy.
Oh,
I understand. There were some things that I
it was, you know, nagging it. Women.
Yeah.
A little bit. It was, but there were some good points in there.
Peacocking.
But I yes. It wouldn't,
don't get me wrong.
It wouldn't age
there's
anymore.
There's stuff in there
that was good.
That worked.
It was like, it was like being around.
To me.
But no, I
yes,
never, I don't know the quotes of it. I just remember the only thing I ever remember from it was that I thought was a brilliant idea was, a group of women, the girl that you're into, talk to her friend.
Mm-hmm. Well,
and I
that's
go, that's,
a
that's
beautiful
just
mind.
Like, that's just, yes, that's
yeah,
not
yeah,
a beautiful
yeah.
mind, which I don't know if they took that, but yes. But that's like, that goes back for ages.
This is just like, hey, like, I've seen it on a Vine, I'm going to do it.
I don't know what it is, but there's a lot of guys are scripted because there was another story I heard that I'll share it with that girl, I guess, because she didn't want me to tell, but like, people talk in code because they like not in code, but like they learn lines and they rehearse it maybe in their brain or at home and they use them on dates all the time.
Like what?
Like, all right. I have a script in a way with dating apps. Like I'm going to say the same stuff for the most part in the beginning.
Oh, really?
Because it
what do
works.
You say?
Well, now I'll do like, let's say we matched
mm-hmm.
and then I'll send, hi, is Alexandra there?
That would work.
That's pretty good.
That would work.
I'm not gonna lie. I remember
but
one
now
time
you can't use it anymore.
I remember one time we were in the very first studio and you were trying to coach someone.
Oh,
and
yeah,
you were like, just give me your phone.
Yeah, I had a
and then five
switch.
Minutes later he was like, oh my god, like I've got a date.
There was like
I think it was for Amir, wasn't it?
I don't know. I don't remember recall, but I just remember telling a lot of people like, get it off the app, get the number, get the number and get off the app. Because if you're on the app, you'll get lost on the app. If you got the number, at least you're inside them personally and they feel a little bit more comfortable. Now you can get to FaceTiming. I'm all about FaceTiming.
Oh, you are.
Way back in the day, it was like when people FaceTime. I can get her on the phone. I'm good.
Yeah. For you, you're a phone guy. Yeah. I'm a FaceTime guy now. No, FaceTiming's big. Have you not been FaceTime dates?
No, FaceTime. I get FaceTime for sure. It's a little bit of an attack, but I do like it.
Well, you don't just FaceTime. You coordinate with them. You go, hey, I'd like to, we should FaceTime before a first date because then you're getting a date in there.
I agree.
I FaceTime with a couple of people and been like, oh, this, thank God. Thank God.
Yeah.
Like I go, oh, this isn't my vibe.
I don't think I ever like someone when I FaceTime with them first.
I think it's just you should try it. And
I do. And
you're saying that when you do it, it makes you not want to go see them.
Yes.
Every time.
Pretty much.
But then maybe you wouldn't have enjoyed. So you're saying that.
Not every time. But like if I don't know them, we're FaceTiming like as like a pre-date. Never goes well for them.
Sounds like it saved you a bunch of time.
Yeah.
Yeah. You also want to go on the date regardless if you like the guy because you want some free dinner.
Ugh, I hate dinner dates.
Yeah, I don't do those unless I really like the person.
Yeah, I'm not one of those girls. I know girls do that and God bless them, but I don't do that unless I'm getting paid.
Well, with food.
Well.
So wait, how what's ideal first date for you?
Drinks.
At a bar?
Yeah, at a bar that's like not too loud.
The Penmar? It's a great first.
Ugh, no.
What, say meet me there? Meet me at the Penmar.
No, I already know that you use that on my friend.
I used it on what friend?
I'm not going to say her name on that.
Oh, the most recent one.
Yeah.
Oh, I did?
You did.
Wow.
But I don't think Penrose is a good date at all.
I think it's a safe place. It's not a date. You're like, hey, I'm going to the Penmar.
Sure.
Why don't you come to the Penmar and meet me? I'm going with, I've said, hey, I'll be at the Penmar with some friends. You should go. It's fun. And if they're like, yes, wow, what a great time. Because now you're not obligated to hang out with them. You're like, I'm going to get a drink. Hey, good to see you. All right, I'll see you in a bit. Like, there's no like, oh, I have to stand next to you the whole time.
Right. And maybe you do vibe and they join your group. If they get along with your group, that's cool. Yeah, I like that.
But
I don't want to do
it. And for the listeners out there, the Penmar is a day, a happy hour environment on a golf course in Venice. And it's blowing up.
With live music.
With live music. It's huge.
Food trucks.
People bring out their blankets and they sit on their blankets and they start there. Everybody goes. Everybody.
It's the place to be seen.
Right now. Yes, right now. It's unbelievable. Like you'll go there and it starts off, people sitting and they're in their groups. It's clingy. But as each hour goes by, people get drunker and drunker and they start mingling. By the time the sun is going down, it's just a free-for-all. It's quick.
It's like 4:30 to 9.
It's 4:30 to 9. And then you're like, at the end, people start going like, where are you going afterwards? What's your number? It's fun. It's so fun and overwhelming. I did have a girl text me because, by the way, I've never been to one place in my life where I saw more matches in my life.
Oh,
I literally was there and there was like so many. I was like, matched with her, matched with her, matched with her. I was like,
you're addicted to dating apps. You were so addicted to dating apps.
So are you.
No, I'm not.
Wait, hold on. How many dating apps do you have on your phone right now?
Just the two.
Hinge, Raya.
Yeah.
And yourself?
Same
Hinge,
thing.
Hinge, Raya. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That's,
but I don't really go on. I don't go
you,
on Hinge.
You know what the apps, you know what apps to be on. We're not on Tinder. We're not. Oh my
Lord. I don't know. I've been out of the dating app game for.
No. Yeah.
Yeah.
But the Penmar place, it's like, it's overwhelming and fun. Oh, okay. So
it's a farmer's market for hooking up.
A girl texted me that I've matched with before and we went on a date. And
where'd you take her?
I went on a double date with her to Wally's, most expensive place just to get a makeout, by the way. Very disappointing.
Beverly Hills?
No, Santa Monica near me. And really good food. It was really good steak.
Really good food. I like
really
that.
Good steak. I would have taken you to Wally's.
If
we had met at this time, at this nice. Point. At that time, I was like, there's no way. I wasn't a Wally. It was more of a coffee date.
Well,
guy.
Yeah, you didn't have any money then. Yeah. You also had roommates and like.
Yeah, but so did you. You had a house of
because
sisters.
I had just gotten out of a relationship.
Yeah, she just left. She was like using some rich guy, and then she broke up with him. But this girl texts me. I get a text after the Penmar. She goes, "You're too old for Penmar."
You are.
No, why? What? There's older people there.
No, there are. There are. That's the cool thing about it. It's a huge demographic.
There are young people, but it's not as young as being out in Venice or Santa Monica.
Right, and also, sometimes there's kids there, and that's weird.
Oh, because the families are bringing kids in the beginning, and they're doing like that silent disco part.
That's a cute line, though. I like that girl.
Yeah? You know her.
Who?
We talked about it. She would hang out at the old place you worked. I told you. Her. Very attractive, but
beautiful girl.
I guess I wasn't her type.
Yeah.
You'll see this clip. But yeah, so.
He liked you.
Yeah, like I him. Liked you.
Yeah.
Well, but I remember we were hanging out. This is a thing that I've dealt with before. I think it was good that she vocalized it. She's like, I don't know about you because I think what your career, what you do gives me anxiety.
And why why would it give you her anxiety?
Maybe she has some sort of like trust issues.
Trust issues.
Well,
that's
understandable. Comedians it's hard to trust a comedian. You're on the road.
You're on the road. You're out late at night shows. There's always women.
They have personalities like you a lot of the time. So it's not trust. You know,
so it's toxic.
Yeah, well, craving
girl sliding
validation.
In the DMs.
Girl slides in your DMs. You say, no, thank you.
Yeah, girl slides in
your
DMs.
You say, no, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I have a friend. And I wonder if I can say this, if I was able to clip this part. I can say it on the long form, but someone we know, but I'm not going to say his name. So and I talked to him about this, and this, what do you think about this? So he's a nice guy. He's a good guy.
Uh-huh.
No promiscuous energy. And he does stand up sometimes. He's not like in it to make it. And he did a show and he goes, bro, for the first time ever, I had a girl slide in my DMs after. And he's in a relationship, long distance.
Mm-hmm.
And he goes, like, I was like, oh, my God. And, like, I opened it and I said, hey, how are you? And that's it. It was very friendly. And I told my girlfriend about it. And I go, what?
Why? What's wrong with that?
Why would you? It's a white lie thing. There's some things you don't have to tell.
Oh, that's true. I mean, girlfriend or wife.
What's the point of telling
you? You could
her?
Just get rid of it.
You could have also because he's not even realizing what he's doing. He goes, because I was feeling guilty. And I go, that's so sweet. You're feeling guilty. But your guilt, you transferred to her.
Mm-hmm.
Because you were feeling bad and now you're making
now
her feel
stressed.
Yes, that's why I said it's selfish. I go, you doing that is worth, there's white lies. Like if when men go on a guy's trip mm-hmm. to Vegas,
right?
If a married man is at a pool and they talk to a girl and they're flirting and it's just for the ego.
Same with a girl. I would
yes,
do that.
Same
if I was
with a girl and you're married. It's just flirting. That's it. You leave. You're not going to go home from the
it's
trip.
Healthy.
And be, yes, you're not going to go home from the trip and be like, oh, I was talking to a girl. You just don't say it. It was for your ego to feel good a little bit. But like, you're not doing anything wrong. But it's not going to make the other person feel good.
Mm-hmm.
So that it's a white lie. It's the same. It's like you don't tell your kids that Santa's fake until they're older.
Right.
You just don't have to tell your wife every single thing.
That's fair. I understand what you mean.
I was just so upset. I go, because now she can take... Well, why would you open up the message?
Right.
Why would you open up the message? That's why. If you reversed it and you found out your girlfriend opened up a message from a guy who slid in, and then you're like, I was just nice. And I said, no, thank you. I appreciate the offer. You're like, well, why did you even open up the message? Because you wanted to feel, you wanted to see if he still had it. Now we got an argument. Now we got a real
now
argument.
Now we're cooking, baby.
Now we're
Let's
cooking,
rock
baby.
And roll, baby.
And maybe that's what you need in your relationship
that's
to have passionate
fair,
sex.
Because I would say guys slide into my DMs all the time, and I wouldn't open them if I was in a relationship. That's not actually true.
That's not
true.
Who
it is.
You would open it. You would like it.
It depends
and you
on who it is. I don't open most of them unless
do you have
cute.
A lot.
Yeah, but they're like weird guys. But sometimes they're cute. You know.
Huh.
I wouldn't if I was in a relationship unless it was like Jake Gyllenhaal. You know what I mean?
That's why you've always been into me. Because I get Jake Gyllenhaal sometimes. Look.
Oh, I can see that with the eyes a little bit.
Hey, look.
All right, stop.
This is making you uncomfortable.
No, I just don't like it.
I'll drop you off after this.
Well, you have to because you picked me up.
Shh. We don't want to make the others jealous.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I didn't go inside. But afterwards, we could maybe grab dinner.
Oh.
Food.
That'd be cute.
We could go to Trader Joe's, get some of those little wraps, those little buffalo chicken wraps.
And we'll just sit on the side of the road.
And then we'll just sit on your little studio and your little IKEA table and eat it.
I don't have an IKEA table.
I'll get you a nice table.
I'd like one, actually. You know what I need is a new chair.
You need a chair?
Oh, my God. So bad.
Okay. Well, the podcast has really failed at this
point.
Well,
anyways. No. Thank you for coming, guys.
What else do we got? Come on, Mark. You got any questions? Oh, this one's great. This is great. This is great.
I'm so scared.
I'm so excited.
No. This isn't anything to be scared about. It's not. Okay. This one's great. Okay. First date. We're on a first date. I'm paying, obviously.
Of course.
Okay? But I pull out a gift card with my card. Come on. Why is that a big deal? Like, are you allowed to do that?
Sure, but I will not be attracted to you.
You would not go on a second date with the guy?
Like, maybe I would.
You've already been to Chili's, apparently.
If you made a joke about it.
Like, I would definitely make a joke. I'd be like, I have this.
Okay.
It's not, I would be like, it's not why I chose the restaurant, by the way.
Right.
Like, I have a $50 for the reason I thought about this, White Whale, is it Killer Whale, the one in Venice, that restaurant?
Oh, you mean, what's wrong with me? I used Great White.
Great White. $50 at Great White, which is nothing at that restaurant, right? Yeah. But I was like, oh, I want to use this, but I don't want to go there and eat by myself.
Why do you have $50 at Great White?
My buddy, I watched his dog and they sent it to me as a gift. Okay, so, and I go.
Instead of cash, okay.
Yeah, which is cool because it makes you go experience.
You don't watch
something.
My dog.
So I think that's true. It's cute.
So I want to use it, but I also don't want to go there alone. And I also don't want to go use it on a guy friend. So I'm like, oh, I'll take a girl that I like enjoy her company there. Maybe I'm not dating it or whatever. But like, how funny if it's like a $200 tab and I put my card down, but I'm like, oh, I also have this $50 thing. Like, that should be okay.
I feel like if you spend $200 and you throw down a $50 gift card, that's totally fine. Because it's like, hey, I'm spending $200.
I agree. But it is funny to think like, that could make a girl go, are
now,
you kidding
me? If it was like a $55 meal and you throw down a $50.
Why? Why does it matter? Why does it matter?
I'm trying to think. I think I would just be like, I think it would make me like embarrassed for you.
But
I don't actually know. Maybe it wouldn't bother me. I can't really.
How bad?
Because I've like, never had someone do that.
I know because it. Okay, but can you do it on the second date? When can you use a gift card?
Wait,
if
could you be that?
Like if a guy had a gift card to Starbucks and he was like, let me get us some coffee. Like I wouldn't care.
Yeah, of course not.
Yeah.
But if he was like, because you would have to set it up with like, by the way, I picked this place, but not because I have this. But you did then. Subconsciously, you did pick the place.
And also, too, Great White is the kind of place you can go get, like, coffee or matcha and
oh,
like
really?
A sandwich to go. Yeah, like, that's something that you could use for yourself, like, every day. You don't have to go there as a restaurant.
Good to know.
Yeah.
Good to know.
Could you be the guy that, like, still uses Groupon?
No, you can't do that.
Yeah. Same thing.
It's different, though.
It's not like, different.
All right, let's say someone gave me a gift card to Craig's, one of the most established, fancy restaurants in all of Los Angeles.
I think that would be worse.
If I brought you to Craig's in Los Angeles.
And you had a gift card, I think that would be worse because it would be like, oh, you definitely couldn't afford Craig's if you didn't have this gift certificate. Whereas Great White, it's more like, oh, like someone just gave this to you as like a gift and it's like cute that you have it. That's different.
She's got a good point.
Okay, so you can't use a gift card
you
on the first date.
You can't use a gift card
not on the
first
date. Take your buddies with you.
No gift card on the first date.
No gift card on the first date unless it's Starbucks and you already have money in your account.
Okay.
But this is just for me, and I'm not a very nice girl. So, like, this, another
I think
girl.
I think you're going to be surprised about how many people are interested in you. I think we're going to have a couple good clips
here. What
do you
think? I don't already have people interested in you, Winkle?
Of course you do, but I think that we'll collab on a really good clip, and I think it's going to I think it's going to change your life.
Oh my God, I hope so.
I think
so.
That you're going to become famous.
The Lenoci effect.
Yeah, maybe that's what I'm the Harvey Weinstein of podcast clips.
Yeah. We're bringing back the takeover.
What?
So we're bringing back the takeover.
Mm-hmm. That's why you picked me up in your car.
Well, just because I knew it would be so difficult for you to figure out where this place is and park a car and then walk. And you don't even really have a car, right? Because you're poor.
Well, yeah. I'm
kidding.
I have a wagon. Money. No, or, not really.
She's from Rhode Island.
I'm from Boston. You know nothing about me.
Your family lives in Rhode Island.
Yeah, my mom lives in Rhode Island.
Oh, I'm so sorry that there was some sort of connection. Boston, by the way. And if you don't know anything about Boston, one of the most heavily dating college towns ever. You went to college there?
No, I went to NYU in New York.
Oh,
Wait, what do you mean heavily dating?
Like, it's such a hookup culture.
Is it?
Because there's so many colleges there.
I guess that's true.
Yeah.
But I feel like people take dating more seriously there, like on the East Coast in general. Like, it's easier to date on the East Coast.
Okay.
Because they're more serious about it.
What's one of the most recent dates you went on that was great?
On the East Coast?
No.
Oh, no, here.
A date, mother effer.
Oh, okay.
Hold on. How about this? Let's get a little juicier. Are you willing to sleep with someone on the first date? Of course.
Yeah, of course. I actually like to sleep with someone on the first date, but don't get any ideas. No, this is not across the board.
That's the clip right there. That's the first line. It's over. That's going viral.
No, she won't do FaceTime.
Block my mom and my dad from this. No, seriously, this is just friend. What?
Okay, you won't do FaceTime. You don't like to FaceTime, but you'll sleep with someone on the first date.
Yeah.
So you do like to sleep with someone else?
No, I don't.
I actually do too.
I'll tell you why. And I'll see if you agree with me. Okay. First of all, I don't like anyone. All right. So if I do like you, and that's no offense, you know, I'm just like picky and like, you have to like be able to keep up with me and like, you have to be hot. It has to be like a perfect mixture. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't, like, I don't have patience. You know, I get the ick quickly. So if I am inclined to hook up with somebody on the first date, it means that the vibes are there and there's chemistry. And I think that like we're all adults and I don't think those rules actually matter. Sometimes they do.
I think younger people. I think once you're in your 30s, it's like,
yeah, once relax. You're in your 30s, it does exactly calm down, you know? And also I actually would go so far as to say, who has a relationship with somebody, like an actual relationship where you like went on the first date and then the second date and then the third date. And then like on the fourth date, you slept together and then you went on the next date and then it evolved and became date. Do people do that? That sounds crazy.
Maybe
I'm
like
always
Nebraska.
Like, if it happens and I'm seeing someone, it's like, bam. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Either it's bam or it's not.
Yeah.
So if I want to have sex with you on the first date and this is the vibe, then I will. But I won't, like, usually it's when they don't live in town.
Ho.
You know, I mean like, I'm saying this doesn't happen all. This is like a rare occurrence.
I was just thinking, I was like, I'm editing this, huh?
Well, stop smacking the.
I have to edit this, huh?
We'll work on it.
Maybe I'll just do a split screen. I think that's just better
for going.
No, I just, it's fine to talk
you
about.
You could do a split screen and then cut it and then split and cut. Like, you could do
it's a lot of work though. I'll do it, but it's fine.
All right, Michael, why do you sleep with somebody on the first date? You like to.
I'll tell you. The reason I like to sleep with someone on the first date is to get that out of the way, so I'm clear minded, and now we can get to know each other. Like, now let's get to know each other.
That's a different reason than me.
But do you agree with what I'm saying? Like, if we I'm with you. Like, on this, if we're on the first date, we're vibing, we have something good, it's going, and we're kissing, and we're into it. Like, let it go all the way. Let's not stop to be like, I don't want to, because like, you like me and you don't want to be judged for it.
That's all it is.
Yes. Yeah. It's like,
but you probably don't want to see the girl again.
That's not true. If I like the girl, like, I'd rather like get past that hump of thinking about that and being like, oh, I wonder if we're going to sleep with each other, or like, I want to know.
Or how many dates do we have to go on before we sleep with each other?
Or just like, I want to know if this connection we have is even as powerful when we sleep with each other.
Yeah.
And then if it is, that's exciting. Now I can be more vulnerable when talking to you.
Right.
Okay. Cause now I'm more open. I'm like, okay, cool. The sex is great. We have chemistry. Now let me tell you everything about me. Let's go. Otherwise, why am I going to tell you everything about me if I don't even know we have good chemistry yet?
Fair.
What's the? If anything, I'm saving us time. This is not going to go well on the internet, but
no.
Still.
Well, but I will say this. If you have sex, and I'm going to give you a girl's perspective so that everyone understands. If you have sex with a girl on the first date,
yes,
okay, and you're not just trying to sleep with her and you're actually interested in her, it is imperative that you like text her, like, you know, it would be nice if you slept over, but if you didn't, or if there's like things or whatever, you got to text her when you get home. You got to text her the next morning. You have to like be on her like immediately. Otherwise, it messes
up their brain. Yeah.
1,000%.
I'm aware of that.
That's super important. And then I think it's cool. But if you like, if you present that you were really into her and that's why you guys had sex and like it was fun and you're thinking about her and you can't wait to see her again, it's fine. Who cares?
Yeah. I agree, Mark.
Yeah.
Why are you looking at me?
Just wondering, you know, what your thoughts were. Could you not maybe look like you're
Well, no, I, I, I agree with everything you're saying, but yes, you are going to get murdered.
Oh, I'm going to get murdered for that one.
Why?
I just know how they.
Oh, come on, ladies. It's okay.
I know how they react to, for me saying, I want to sleep with you because I want to get it out. Like, it just, I know what triggers the internet now. It's almost like I can.
Okay, so then why do you think that you want to, like, why is that though? Like, do you feel nervous about yourself sexually so that, in the sense that, like, you feel like you need to get out of the way so that to see if they'll like you sexually? Is it about you or is it about them?
No, it's about, like, knowing if it's part of me being a guy obviously wants to get laid too? Yes. Part of me, right. is it part of it being horny? Sure. Obviously, right? But it maybe it's a little eagerness. Yeah, because it's like, let's just have fun. Yeah. So I know they're going to like it.
Saying. It's different with you. What I'm saying is I sometimes like to have sex with a guy on the first date because we really connected and we're vibing and it's based in that person. It's not based in the fact that I need to have sex in that moment. But for you, it might be based in the fact that you want to have sex in that moment, which is why people get mad. That's where the disconnect is. Are those Yeezys?
Yes.
Cool.
Does that affect you?
No, not at all. I just find them sort of weird looking, but I think they're cute also too. I've seen those.
I stand with the Jews.
Yeah.
In Yeezys.
Appreciate that.
Actually, I stand with anyone. Go Palestine too.
One for president, female.
Yeah, yeah. Whatever, yeah. Whatever makes you happy. Right. As long as football's on, I'm happy. Okay. What? Older guys?
What about them?
You like older guys?
I think that men in their 40s in Los Angeles are the root of all evil. Single men in their 40s in Los Angeles are the root of all evil. That's my opinion. And I'm so sorry to tell you that. Am I right or am I wrong?
Why?
Am I right or why? Why? I could write a dissertation about this.
Oh, man. Why 40? Because I just got to 40.
Qualify.
Exactly. Exactly. Because they've been living in LA. They're in their 40s. Like, they've been single this whole time.
Would you say it's Peter Pan syndrome?
It's Peter Pan syndrome. They sort of present like they're mature and articulate and like they're able to like, you know, and they're able to like talk to you about feelings, but they're also like a little boy at the same time and they're like lying directly to your face. But like, they're not.
I do not lie.
But they're not.
You're just getting bodied.
Yeah. And they're not like facing it though. They've got all these sort of insecurities that they've built such beautiful, strong walls around for so long because they're men in their 40s. And so it's like they're impermeable in terms of that, but they also are like,
you're right. She is fun.
Yeah.
Not true. I am telling
She's
you right
really
now.
She's really attractive when she performs.
Thank you very much. No, let me tell you. I had the word. I can't say it online because he's an actor.
Yeah, but was he follows you?
Can we
tell the story though?
I can tell. Well, yeah, it's
you
kind
don't have
of,
to use his name.
It's a little dark though. I don't know if I'm
oh, come on. Wait,
it's a little dark.
Like sexual harassment dark?
No, but like it's like has to do with like death and stuff like that. I don't really remember.
I mean, you can't just leave us hanging
well,
right now.
Well, I will just say that like a guy in his 40s in Los Angeles did the worst thing to me.
I got it. Yeah, I want to hear.
The worst thing to me, and I've dated and I've bailed men out of jail before. Okay. You know what I'm saying? So it ain't like I haven't had this experience.
East Coast trash vibe.
Well, it was the Irish guy. So it's not like I haven't had bad things happen to me, but this one was so incredibly unique.
Oh, come on. What is this? Just say it. I how about this? You could phrase it like this. My friend was dating this guy and this happened to her. What happened to her?
Okay.
What happened to your friend?
My friend was dating this guy. Well, my friend had been seeing this guy on and off for months and they'd sort of like stopped talking and then they kind of had rekindled. He was going out of town to be in a show. And so he was going to be gone for like 10 months.
He was gone for work.
Gone for work. And they had sort of rekindled right before he left. And when he was gone, he was texting her saying how he couldn't stop thinking about her. Like, he's going to be coming back to LA. And at the same exact time, her stepfather was in hospice. And he was going to be passing probably within 10 days. And he knew that. Like, uh-huh. It had just happened the week prior. it happened like a couple days before they had rekindled and all of this stuff. So he said that he was coming back to Los Angeles to get rid of, tie up some loose ends. And he would love to see her, like, you know, he can't wait to see her. And she said, well, I'm going to visit my stepdad for a couple days, basically to say goodbye to him.
Back home. And he knew for what reason.
He knew for what reason. And it just, and I, and she said, but I'm going to be landing back in LA at this time on this day. Maybe it would coincide. And basically he said, oh, that actually is perfect because I'm landing in LA at that same time. So I can be there for you and blah, 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 blah. Uh-huh. So he waited for her at the airport for 3 hours.
That's very sweet.
Very sweet. Until her flight landed. And she was a mess. She'd been crying on the plane. You know, she just said goodbye to her stepfather.
Of course. And by the way, just to jump in, if I'm doing this for a girl, I'm not thinking about hooking up at all. I'm thinking about emotionally just being like, oh, let me show her how much I can. Because if I'm doing that, then I'm like, oh, I want to date this girl. So I want to show her that I can be emotionally strong enough for her.
And if a girl is going to be vulnerable like that in front of a guy and he's waiting for her at the airport for 3 hours, then she thinks that that's what's happening.
Yes.
To a degree. I mean, she's open to that.
I agree.
You know, and she's also feeling safe and comfortable to be vulnerable with that person.
I agree.
So he waited for her at the airport. You know, he took care of her. He carried all of her stuff. She had her car parked at the airport. So he drove her car back. They went back to his place. He needed to go to the DMV the next day to deal with his license. So she drove him to the DMV. He didn't have a car because he had driven it across country. She took him to the DMV. They spent the entire day together. She was very fragile, but it was like very intimate and sweet. Went to the DMV with him. Like, he was leaving a day and 2 days later. And so she thought in her mind that they were probably going to hang out the entire time while he was in town. He's only in town for a few days, you know. And at the end of that second day, he said that he needed to get some work done and whatever. So she left. The next day they had plans. He canceled on the plans like last minute and said he had to go to this reunion. The next day was the last day he was there. He invited her over during the day to say a quick goodbye to him because he had plans that night. And she had a feeling about it. Something weird was going on, you know, but she felt like she had to get in front of him. She goes to his house and he said that he was going to see a friend that just had a baby. And she said to him, I have a question. While you're in town, are you like sleeping with other women or are you just seeing me? And he was like, well, why are you asking this? That's so like, you're not that kind of girl. I'm like, I'm not that kind of girl, but I have a right to know. I would love to know.
At this point, you guys are sleeping with each other.
Oh, yes.
Even since you got back.
Yeah.
You've slept with him with your trauma.
I slept with him that night. I slept in his bed. Oh, she slept with him that night. She slept with him that night. She slept in his bed. They went to the DMV together. They spent the entire day together.
So you asked that, and you were having a feeling he's checking in with all of them while he's back.
Wow. She just had a feeling, and then he said that he was seeing a friend with a baby, and she looked at him and she said, "Are you seeing a girl tonight?" Long story short, it turns out that the day So he picked her up from the airport. She slept over. The next day they went to DMV. That night he went and took a girl on a first date that night. And then the next night he canceled on her and had sex with a different girl. And then the next night day he invited her over to say goodbye. And he was going on a second date with the girl he'd taken on a first date that second night. Basically they were together. And he revealed it all to her. And her father was
being honest. Mm-hmm. Now, let me give you a male's perspective.
All right, tell me.
Sounds like he's successful.
I would say that he is successful on a show that no one has ever heard of before.
But so, he does well for himself.
He does all right.
I mean, it's on Netflix, but nobody watches it.
It's not on Netflix. But yeah. I guess it has a following.
Here's the problem. I guess... Now he's welcome to do all of that if he was communicating with you that
if he was honest.
I'm not looking for anything serious.
Of course.
But also, if I was in F-boy mentality, right? And even if there was a girl I liked, I'm not doing that airport thing.
You're not doing the airport thing.
I am zoned in on like, oh, I really like this girl. Otherwise, I'll be like, oh, it sounds like you're going for, let me know if you need anything. I'm doing that. Let me know if you need anything. If we're around, maybe we got coffee. I'm not doing the airport thing the for airport anyone thing. Unless it's someone I've talked to for, that's visiting.
It but was like, and such the DMV. A charade. The DMV too, the whole day at the
that's
DMV.
That's like the two worst places.
Yeah. The DMV and the airport, it was so, there was so much theatrics to it, you know? I'm here
actors
for
are,
you.
Actors are the worst.
It was theatrics and this. And then wait, and then when I...
Sorry, no continue. Please. I was going to say, where do you put actors or comedians?
No,
worse?
Actors are just the worst as humans. Well, at least a comedian say, can be like can reveal some sort of vulnerability.
Who's
an actor,
more toxic?
An actor
actors
can be
or comedians?
A goddamn like a sociopath that you don't even
I
know.
I think it depends on what type of actor. I think men who are on procedurals are worse because they're trapped in this formulaic type of job, so they feel like they have to get their like well, I'm a star stuff out.
Explain a procedural.
A procedural is a show like, you know, Law and Order or you know, a show where it's like every episode
same
is
thing
some,
every day this, yeah. Whereas a serial
the,
is
for the audience.
There's a formula
yeah
to the show,
so those type of actors are the worst types to date
if they're single in their 40s in Los Angeles. This is a theory I have,
yeah, no, I
but
like
I've
it.
Tested it twice.
Because they're stuck in this like world.
They're stuck in this like formula, but they're also actors. So when they step out of it, they've got this sort of like this Peter Pan syndrome, but also this sort of narcissism that isn't being fulfilled in their day-to-day work life.
You think this is funny? But I want to touch base on this Peter Pan syndrome before we get out of here. Because I think a lot of women use that with guys that get older, but it's like I understand that there is a Peter Pan syndrome thing. And I think that goes more to like a regular person who has a 9-to-5 job that would be 40 and single still. But when it comes to an artist who is pursuing a career, which is arguably one of the hardest things to pursue,
oh,
it's
exhausting.
Like, it's like not Peter Pan. It's more like it's selfish. You are, I've chose to be selfish and there's nothing wrong with that, but it's like, I have to succeed in what I'm doing.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm an actress and I have to be selfish too, yeah, in a lot of ways. So I'm sympathetic to it.
Yes.
But you also have to be an honorable person and you have to be like real. And there's a reason why you're only going to reach this level of success because you're actually not real in real life. That's why I don't think actors are as toxic as you think they are if they're a good actor. Because you have to be really smart to be an actor and you have to be real.
Yeah.
So I think it just depends. I don't think that it's like a blanket statement.
So if I make it to 50 and we still haven't got married, then we get married?
Oh, we're starting a tontine.
Oh, he's in love with
what
me.
Is it called?
It's called a tontine.
Is that what
that's,
it is?
That's really? The name of it's like, hey, it's like a contract of like, you know, okay, a group of friends where like the last person gets the treasure at the end, or two people who like, hey, if we get to 35 and we're not married, we'll let's just do it. We'll get married. It's called a tontine.
Yeah, a tontine.
T-O-N-T-I-N-E.
I better get married before 50.
Tontine.
Yep.
I never agreed to this, Michael.
You would.
Why would I agree to it? What's married?
If it's on camera, it's binding.
What's married life going to be for us?
I'm actually ordained here.
Yeah, for sure.
So
I'd like to travel.
If we had money and we were able to travel,
oh,
we'd
hell
have fun.
Yeah, we'd have a lot
do
of
do you
fun.
Think we would be able to have a functioning open
sex
relationship?
Life? No.
You couldn't do that?
No, I don't want to have an open relationship.
Could you have a threesome?
No.
With another girl?
I'd rather be with a girl alone than with a guy there. I don't even
know. Like, here's the thing. If you two were in an open relationship.
Yeah.
Could you be
it
in
would
an open
be competitive as hell.
That's right.
I don't know. I mean, there's would be no
would
point.
Get
be no,
yeah, would
there'd
get
be
jealous.
No, there'd be no point in dating her because, like, I think there was a couple times where there was good sexual chemistry, but then maybe there wasn't at the
don't
end.
Look at me.
I don't know. It was 6 years ago. Just remember the mirror.
All right, relax.
Okay, too far.
Wait, was the mirror on the ceiling or something?
No.
Were you just like, what am I looking at?
Stop looking. No, he literally just looked at me out of the corner of his eye, and that's so annoying. Like,
wait. No, I don't want to ask. No.
Ask.
No, I really don't.
We got to respect her boundaries.
Don't. Yeah.
She specifically said no juices and liquids. She didn't say that.
I never
I just
said
made
that,
that
but
up.
Yeah. Okay. No juices.
Do you have anything else that you think we could get off? Dating topics?
I got nothing.
Dating apps. We did dating apps. We did her dating.
I have a question.
Okay.
What is one thing that a girl could do on a first date that would turn you off? Like one specific thing.
Sloppy drunk.
Interesting. Okay.
Like, yeah, like obviously going, like even if we drank a lot, but she can't like keep it a little like where like there's nothing in her head that is like, well, let me not get too sloppy.
For me, it's doom scrolling.
What's, like, on a date?
What's doom scrolling? Well,
like when a girl's just checking her phone.
Oh, yeah. That's
it's
gross.
Like, oh, just.
Well, but then that's you not reading the room that she's not into it.
Yeah. And you're just wasting my time and you're wasting your time.
She's not doing that if she's into
that's
it.
That's so rude to do when you're with anyone. That's bizarre.
Sure. If I do it, I'm like, oh, hey, I'm so
like
sorry.
Like the wife and I, yeah, like, I just hand her my phone and I say, hey, put it in your purse. Like,
oh, yeah. No, if phones. A work thing comes up, I'd be like, I'm so sorry. Do you mind if I just like really quickly? Yeah.
Wait, that's fine.
Yeah.
What's giving you an ick? I have a couple icks. There was one recent, but I'm not going to say it. Oh, I want it.
Why?
Yeah.
In case
Michael Anochi's top three icks.
Because I post it and that person follows and I don't want to hurt their feelings.
Oh, my God, Michael, please.
Sad set.
Can you just?
It's shallow.
Oh, I want to know what it is.
Okay. I'll tell you afterwards because it's not likable.
Ah.
So it's just like not. I shouldn't put it out there.
Yeah.
But I'm admitting that it's shallow and unlikable. But I'll tell you after.
But we all have our thing that's shallow.
What's one of your ex?
In general, men who, oh God, there's so many, men who wear sandals. Like, especially guys who wear flip-flops with jeans. That is a terrorist attack. Like, it's like it's a highlight. It's so bizarre. It's like a highlight on your foot. The pant ends at the foot and we go to the foot. Like, why are you so cocky?
That was like a bar, college bar thing for
yeah,
sure.
But
that,
I've seen,
I guess as an adult, but flip-flops, if you're at the beach, what are we talking about?
I mean, that's fine if we're at the beach. I just won't look at you.
What if like you went to the beach and then we moved to a bar on Venice because there's that boardwalk area? Oof, like how there's got to be you got to be allowed to.
I mean, you can. I don't like you that much anymore.
Got you.
That's all that it. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not going to stop you from doing anything. Like, maybe I would. Maybe I wouldn't mind it. But I'm telling you, for whatever reason, and not for whatever reason, it bothers me.
Hmm.
But it's okay. It depends. It's if it's your vibe, then that's cool.
Do you think you're difficult to date?
No, not at all. I just went on a date with someone who was wearing sandals. It horrified me, but I stayed on the date. You know.
Do you want to get married and have kids? Oh wow.
I know I do. I don't need to.
Same. I don't need to.
I don't need to, but it
would
be.
But if it happened,
that's where it happened, then absolutely. I need to like have a fulfilling life and career and like to achieve all my dreams and like never stop pursuing what I love to do. I need that. I don't need to get married and have kids. Like, I'd like it. I'd love
okay
to be alone.
To be alone.
I don't think I'll be alone.
I don't mean it like that. I'm saying like we're both single and we both live alone and we both are pursuing our art and our career. And
I'm fine being alone.
And I'm fine being alone. Like I'm never laying there going like,
Oh my God, please. Yeah, I would rather. Oh my God, please.
And then we both have our ways of reaching out to people to take care of our.
Right.
So at 45. At 45.
Yeah.
If you're still single. This taunting's happening.
I'll meet other people to make it at 44 with other people. We would get divorced.
It's so interesting. Michael is so in love with me, but he is convincing himself that he's not.
Yeah,
he's
but
not.
You,
have you noticed that?
But
about
don't
him?
You understand that? Like,
I think
all you do is you marry her, and then you'll be the attractive married guy.
Here's and what you it continue is. Can I be honest about life? Alexandra? I keep good relationships with a lot of people I've casually dated or even have seriously dated, but besides one from like 15 years ago. But like I'm friends with my ex-girlfriend still. We talk and we openly could talk about dating.
Was this the one who was in the studio?
Oh, Haley?
Yeah.
Yeah, Haley and me still talk. We're still friends. But like I always stay friends with everyone I'm dating. So I'm always like still, I think she's beautiful and very attractive. And I think you have a hell of a personality that's fun.
Oh, that's good. I feel the same way about you.
Yeah. But like, I think that if we were like Monday, Tuesday,
I think
Wednesday,
you're cuter too these days. Yeah. You look cute.
Well, because I'm more manly. Oof. Is it the beard?
I don't know about it. Maybe that's what it is. Maybe that's what, maybe you know what it is? You've settled into yourself. It's like an energy thing.
I think I love you.
Really?
As a person.
All right, keep going. But no, I do read that energy though.
You're really good at dressing up. Like you look really good.
Oh, really?
Like this is not how she looks in the morning.
I didn't even like blow dry my hair.
No, you know what it is always about you? That's what you're very, you're very sexy. It's very sexy and exert sexual energy.
Oh.
Like I get every guy, like when you're in a room, like guys can probably, they're like, who the fuck, who's this?
Yeah.
They're going like, who's this? And you know that and you love it. And I'll bet you it makes other women intimidated.
I'm a little bit of a witch. No, but this is the thing. It's like, I'm very sweet with other women and I love women. I don't think women.
I've seen it in reaction with your,
I think
your friend.
Maybe in the past it intimidated other women, but I think that I've been able to like maneuver that. And like, I'm really, I think I give off as much energy as I give off, like, you know, manipulating men. I also give off the same level of energy.
You think you're really good at manipulating men?
No. I also give that same level of energy off to like being welcoming to women. That's why I sense that women
have been intimidated by you.
No, I don't think that they are. Like maybe in the past they have been, but I don't.
Yeah, because if you walk in a room and you're tipsy. You tipsy walking in a room, you're making even the guy who's been married 10 years go.
No, I'm a good girl. I'm a good girl. No, that's not true.
You like it. Trump could walk in and you'd be like, I'm going to get him to grab me.
No, Trump would walk in. I would totally play around with Trump. Are you kidding me? Who wouldn't though? Wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Wouldn't you like want to like fiddle with
poke
Trump?
At him?
Yeah,
100%.
Totally.
I mean, that's why him, Theo interviewing him was,
I know,
just fascinating.
Yeah.
I was like, what world am I in?
That what world
a comedian
am I in?
Got up to a point.
Yeah.
Wow.
Bizarre, but cool. Very cool.
All right. Well, I think we did our, what are we at? Do you know?
70 minutes.
Oh, what? Well, we started 10 minutes in. We got an hour in.
Yeah, are you happy with that, Michael? Do you feel good? Do you
I think we got a
cover
lot.
Anything? I think we got a lot.
I think we got a lot that would right. be fun to cut up. Yeah, I'm done.
Do you
man.
Do any out? Like you don't say goodbye, everyone?
goodbye, yeah, a little everyone. Bit. I'm like, all right, guys, well, that's it. It's just so cheesy now.
Right.
It's
right,
a
right,
podcast,
right.
So it's like, all right, guys, that's our episode. Make sure I put like now I have a thing at home where I'll put like a flyer in the beginning with and put and like maybe I'll do a voiceover here if you could maybe put this in the beginning. Hey guys, check out my dates, michaelonoji.com, right? And
yeah,
then it'll be in the beginning.